You can call me a madman, but I'm spoken for. You can take my possession, gives me an open door.
Yeah. All right, my name is Sean Rowe, and I've landed in Wolfgang's vault. This is a song called Old Black Dodge. Vincent Black Lightning, 1952.
a girl feel special in such a night. Searching to rip my leg. My hat's on to you. It's a Vincent Black Lightning 1952. And I've seen you on the corners and the cafes, it seems. Red hair and black leather, my favorite color scheme. And I pulled along. I'm gonna give you my Vince to ride. Searching to rip my leg. Here's a ring for your right hand. But I will tell you what, I'm a dangerous man. As I fought with the law since I was 17, then I robbed middlemen to get my Vincent machine. When I turned 21 and I made me 22, but I don't mind dying if I swallow love with you. Oh, but if fate, taking young James in an armed robbery, shackled blades to his chest, left nothing beside. Well, come down to his dying bed. When they brought him to the hospital, there wasn't much left. Running out of road, he was a running out of breath. Oh, but his smile, oh, to see him try, said, I'm gonna give you my Vince to ride. Sir James, in my opinion, there ain't nothing in this world beats a 52 Vince and a red-headed girl. Now breezes and mountains, and it won't do. I'm not afraid.
was
up.
We'll use them both. Parts
1 and 2. This is a song of mine. This is called The Walker.
Thank you.
I got so high that the seasons changed. I watched the silver turn to gold. I drank my life, I was chasing it down. It didn't have no place to go. I should have known I woke the devil up. I should have heard the engine roar. The road was shaking, but my hands were still. But I'm not to dance on my own. I let the dash, I took my sunglasses off. I like to see the fun go. Remember at the school, at the sky, the park. Trading in our stories for the dark. In our heads, in our own way. Remember Megan with her makeup off. She made us dream, she got us off. It was good that she moved away. Somebody laughing in the wind. I should have felt the rain on my left hand. I should have heard the devil grin. But it came from the other side. I could feel the steel explode. The sound of thunder covered up my eyes. A little screaming in my throat. The moon was raining down.
Magazine, and I'm here with Sean Rowe, who just did a pretty amazing session for us here at the Vault, and he's kind enough to stick around and answer some of our questions. So welcome.
Thank you.
I'm glad and to be here. I guess we'll get started with kind of the basic. How did you come to be a songwriter, musician, and I mean, did you grow up in a musical household or?
When I was five, I was forced at gunpoint.
Oh yeah.
To play music. when I was early on, actually, when I was seven, I started writing songs on a little plastic typewriter that my mother got me for Christmas. Cool. that actually worked, you know. So I was writing songs early on, but my family was very musical, and I learned guitar, started playing guitar when I was about 12.
Do you remember your first gig?
Yeah.
How'd that go?
Well, my first like bona fide gig was this place called Saratoga Winners, which used to be an old potato chip factory, but they converted into this sort of kind of sleazy venue, you know, but it was a real, real rock club. I was really nervous.
How old were you at that time?
I was 18 years old. Oh. You know, it was my, I had a band at the time. I was playing bass and singing. That was my first, like, whoa, it was scary.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. And you've got Record Magic coming out on Anti on February 22nd.
Yeah.
Can you kind of give us a little insight on how the writing and recording process went for that?
No, it took about a year and a half to do the album, not because it's so complex or anything, just because of scheduling mostly. But I'd recorded it on my own with some friends in upstate New York, producer by the name of Troy Pohl, a good friend of mine. And he produced the record, and, you know, the songs were written over... Half of the songs were written as we were going, you know, as we were recording. So it was kind of fresh in that way. And then Anti picked it up after we recorded it.
Cool. Yeah. Do you know how they came across your staff or?
It was kind of, I think it was a little bit of chance involved through my manager just being in the right place at the right time.
And, being a good manager.
yeah. And Anti, you know, they liked the record as it was, you know, we didn't make any changes to it.
Oh, cool. Nice. So when I listen to the record, the songs on Magic, I definitely get kind of a blues undertone and like touches of the balladeers, like, I don't know, like Leonard Cohen or Tom Waits. Were those touchdowns for you when you were recording, or those influences on you?
I draw from all that stuff, you know, and early, like almost primitive sounding blues, you know, Mississippi Delta stuff, you know, and just really raw sounds, you know. I've always drawn from that, and the songwriting aspect of it. I mean, I've always been influenced by Dylan and Leonard Cohen. Just the level of passion and you know, intensity in the writing is important.
Yeah, well, I find intriguing about lyrically, like your work is. You can, in one song, you can go from this kind of vivid narrative to these more abstract, open to interpretation images. Can you kind of give us an insight into your method as a songwriter? Like, where do you start, or what?
Well, I don't know that I have much of a method. You know, I guess it's different for everybody, but I tend to write, I tend to sing kind of like, almost like mumbles, you know, they're not really words or anything. And I'll come up with like, you know, usually the music to the song and these like nonsense kind of, but some of them are words, you know, but I feel like the song is in there somewhere, you know what I mean? And it's all about pulling it out and making it real. Like, you know, like if I feel that it's like contrived, you know what I mean? That I'm just pulling something out of there for no reason, you know, just to sound poetic or something. It doesn't sit right with me. You know what I mean? It has to work. But I feel like it's in there. It's like chipping away, you know,
and it's still getting process.
Yeah.
Well, it definitely does not come off as contrived at all.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. It's very, very cool stuff. And then I guess I remember right, you toured the last summer. You toured the UK with
No One the Whale. Yeah.
How did that come about and how did it go?
I had 4 days to prepare for that trip.
Oh, really?
My co-manager in the UK. Set that up, and it was just like basically, you know, we have this really cool opportunity with this band, and he made it sound a little bit like there was a little bit of a negative tinge to it, and I was like, that's a no-brainer, man, I'm there. And he's like, well, the only thing is you have
four days.
So, you know, he decided, but you know, it was a great tour.
So they kind of found you and just were like, we want this guy to tour with us. And
yeah, there was a booking agent out there who was a fan of my stuff and put me on there, you know, without really hearing me live either. Cool. You know what I mean? So that meant a lot to me, you know, somebody willing to take a chance like that.
Was that your first time touring the UK?
No, in 2005 I was on a pub tour.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, which is pretty interesting.
Cool.
Yeah.
Nice. And kind of, I also understand that in addition to music, your other passion in life is kind of the natural world, wilderness living, things like that.
Yeah.
Which I think makes sense, kind of given, I mean, a lot of your music has like this kind of open space to it, and there's a lot of natural imagery in it.
Right.
Could you kind of give us a background on what naturalisticism, I think it might pronounce that right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It is, and maybe if you see any kind of parallels between that and your music.
Yeah, I do, in that nature is very raw for me and real and powerful and emotional, and all those things are in the music that I love, you know. So I pull images from nature, you know, into the songwriting because I think they're really powerful, just like religious imagery is powerful, you know. But I've been in the woods since I was a kid, you know, just like always fascinated by nature and the mystery and the awe of it all, you know. Native Americans and how they survived off of the land and how they lived. And so I spent a lot of time, I still do, you know, when I can, and still go out and forage wild plants and stuff like that. I'm passionate about it. So,
awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. Well, it definitely shows through both in that and then in your music as well.
Yeah. I want to write a song about black walnuts.
Oh yeah.
But I don't think it's going to work.
You do a lot of like the kind of, I don't know what you would call it, I guess, not raw food, but like you actually go out on wilderness hikes and things like that and eat off the land and mushrooms and things like that.
Yeah, yeah, when I can. I'm in the Northeast, upstate New York, so there's, you know, we got maybe a 5-month harvesting season, you know.
Cool.
Which is cool.
Right. Did you do farming or anything like that? Or?
No, I'm not really a gardener per se. That's my phone. Do you see that?
Yeah.
Sorry.
We can roll with it.
I do live in the modern world as well, so sometimes my cell kind phone of goes off and when I'm out in the woods, you know. I'll find spots around my house, you know, and, you know, people's backyards. You don't even realize how much stuff is out there, you know.
Cool.
So awesome. It's pretty wild.
Well, thanks for coming in.
Yeah.
And again, the record comes out February 22nd, Magic. Yeah, yeah. Be sure to check that out. And make sure you watch the rest of Sean's vault session here. And again, thanks for coming by.
All right, man. Thanks for having me.
Take it easy.
All right.